So good morning friends, today we have discussed the design of continuous beam using the concept of redistribution of moment. In the first lecture we have already discussed the concept of the redistribution of beam and the concept of the plastic hinge. Now as per IS 456/2000 clause number 22.41 we can find out the maximum bending moment for the different combination of the load. First, design load, dead load on all the span with full design imposed load on two adjacent span. This condition is applied for the to find out the maximum bending moment for the support at continuous support. And second, design dead load on all span with full design imposed load on the alternate span. This combination of load is used to find out the maximum bending moment at the mid span. Now, as per the clause number 22.7, page number 36, IS 456/2000, redistribution of moment may be done in accordance with the clause number 37.1.1 for limit state method and in accordance with the B1.2 for the working stress method. Now, we have taken one example. This is the continuous beam ABCDEF and we can find out the maximum moment. First, we have find out the maximum moment at the mid span, say at AB. Now we have find out the maximum bending moment in the span AB. That's why we can apply the maximum load over the AB, and in the another span we can provide the only minimum load, or we can say that the dead load, design dead load. Then for CD again maximum load, and for DE again minimum load, like that. And using this combination we get the maximum bending moment in the span AB, mid span of AB and mid span of CD. Then we can change the loading combination. In the first span we have provided the minimum load, second span where we need the maximum bending moment, that is the span moment in the span BC and in the span CD. And that means using these two combination we get the maximum moment in the mid span of all the span. Third combination, to find out the support moment at support, this is, we have considered this is the simple support, that's why no need to find out the support moment at A, it is already zero. But when we find out the bending moment at continuous support B, we can provide the maximum load, that is the design load on the adjacent span, and next we have provided the minimum load. And using this combination we get the maximum moment in the span B and for the span B and for the span E. Similarly, to find out the maximum design moment for the support C, again we can provide the maximum load on the adjacent span and minimum load next to the adjacent span. And then we get the negative bending moment at span C, similarly for span D. In this way, we can find out the support moment. This is the different cases. Now, for example, we have considered the two span B, say AB and BC. With the LE1 is the one span and LE2 is the another span, and this is the bending moment diagram, WL square by 8 for the span 1 and WL square by 8 for the span 2 or second span, and MB is the bending moment at the continuous support B. And this can be done either by Laplace theorem, that is three moment theorem, or moment distribution method, Carnier method. You can use any convenient method. And this is the standard case when we have considered the maximum load with continuous beam. Here the moment is there, at here moment at A we have considered zero, and that's why we can use the two, we can find out the support reaction or shear at support A. From case number one we get the maximum shear force in the at support A, that is WLE by 2 for the first span AB plus MA minus MB, already MA is 0, divided by LE for the AB, we get the shear force. Similarly, we can find out the X max, that is the maximum distance, to find out the maximum bending moment. As we know that this is the parabolic, the variation of the bending moment is parabolic, and that's why the maximum bending moment never occur at the center. It is toward the left support. And so we can find out either by using this combination, or we can simply find out the maximum bending moment at the mid span. Actually, there is no large variation, hardly 3 to 5% variation is there. And so either using X max, MU max, or we can find out the maximum bending moment at the center. Now this is the second case. Now in second case, we can find out the maximum midspan moment in the second span BC. Again, minimum load, that is the design load WD, and the maximum load, that is 1.5 WD plus WL over the second span. And using this combination, we get the again bending moment diagram. It is WL square by 8. This is the WL square by 8 for AB, WL square by 8 for the BC, and this is the NB. And after redistribution, say 30% is permitted in a limit set method, and that's why this MB is the 100%, and 30% of this, that means this is 70%. So we get the this to this, that will be the net positive bending moment in the span AB, and from this point to this point, that will be the maximum span moment in the span BC. From case number 2, we can find out the maximum design moment in the span BC. And from case number 1, we get the maximum design span in the span AB. Now from case number 3, we can provide the design load on the adjacent span so that we get the maximum design moment in the continuous support B. And using this case also, we can get the design shear force, maximum shear force in the B to A support and B to C. Now we have considered one example. Similarly, using the different case number 1, case number 2, case number 3, this is related with the, this is called as the bending moment envelope. This is from the case number 1, this is from the case number 2, and from case number 3, maximum bending moment, and this is maximum bending moment for the BC, and this is the MB for the all three cases. This is the bending moment envelope. Similarly, we have considered the shear force envelope. Here I have shown only maximum shear force from case number 1, VA is there. From case number 2, we can find out the VC, and from case number 3, we can find out the shear force at continuous support V, B to A and V, B to C. Now this is the maximum bending moment and shear force from the different all three cases. Now we have consider one example. Design a continuous beam ABC as shown in figure using 30% redistribution moment for the following data. Now the design load over the AB and BC is same, 20 kN per meter. Live load on the beam AB and BC is 9 kN per meter. Effective span of AB is 6 meter and for BC is 4 meter. Material M20 and E415. Assume suitable data if needed. Now in this case, step number 1, assume the size of the beam. In this case, I have considered 230 mm is the width and 500 is the overall depth of the both beam AB and BC. Effective span is already known to us, that is 6 meter for AB and 4 meter for the BC. Design load on the beam, here we have considered W minimum, that is the minimum load is equal to dead load, that is 20 kN per meter for both the beam. And W max is equal to 1.5 WD plus WL. So it is 43.50 kN per meter for both the beam. Now calculate the maximum bending moment using the either Clapeyron's theorem, that is three moment theorem, or moment distribution method, or any other convenient method. Now this is the case number 1. Maximum design load over the beam AB, that is 43.50, and dead load, that is 20 kN per meter over the beam BC. And we get the maximum bending moment. This green line indicates the maximum bending moment for the AB after 20% redistribution. Moment at B is equal to 133.45, and after 20% redistribution, that means this multiplied by 0.8, we get the 93.514. So we get the, from this point to this point, that will be the midspan moment in the span AB. But one more interesting thing is that for this case, if we apply the minimum load on the BC, span is less, load is also less, and that's why we get the negative bending moment in the span BC from this. That is minus 6.76 kN meter. Now case number, from case number 1, we can use the, I have used here a Clapeyron's theorem, that is 3 moment theorem. MA multiplied by L1 plus twice MB, L1 plus L2, both span, plus MC multiplied by L2. That is equal to WU1 LE1 cube divided by 4 plus WU2 LE2 cube divided by 4. This is the standard case. And that's why moment at A, moment at C is 0, being a simple support. and that's why we get the 20 multiplied by MB is equal to this one. We get the MB, that is 133.45, and after 30% redistribution we get 93.514. Similarly, using the standard cases, we can find out the shear force at A, support A. This is the 114.93 kN. Now the case number, now one more interesting thing is that maximum bending moment, as I have already discussed in the previous slide, bending moment at the center is not maximum due to the parabolic bending moment behavior. But this difference is not very large. So take bending moment at the center of the span, which is simple to calculate. For small span, there is a chances to develop negative bending moment for WD on that span, as in case of our case number 1. So maximum bending moment for AB, we get the 148.99, and maximum bending moment for BC, it is negative, minus 6.707 kN. Now this is the case number 2. We can find out the maximum bending moment in the span BC. That's why we can provide the design load here and the minimum load on the span AB. Again, we get the WL square by 8 for BC. This is the maximum bending moment at B, that is the continuous support, and after 30% redistribution it is 62.16, and we get this is the positive bending moment in the span BC, that is 55.92, and for this is positive, no problem. So using this, again repeat the Clapeyron theorem, we get the MB after 30% redistribution, it is 62.16, and we can find out the shear force at support C, which is maximum from case number 2, and maximum bending moment in the span BC, that is 55.92. Now case number 3, from case number 3 we can find out the support moment, continuous support at B. That's why we can provide the design load on the adjacent span. And again, WL square by 8, and this is the 152.25 kN is the maximum moment at support B using the Clapeyron theorem. And after 30% redistribution, it is 106.575. So from this case number 3, repeat the same procedure, we can find out the shear force, which is maximum at support B, and we can find out B toward A and B toward C. This is the maximum shear force, 148.26 and 113.64, and maximum design moment at B is equal to, after 30% redistribution, 106.572. Now these are the bending moment envelope. This is the bending moment envelope. We have plugged all these three cases and we get the maximum bending moment in BC, AB, maximum bending moment in BC from case number 1, it is negative, and maximum bending moment for the support B, case number. This is the shear force envelope. From case number 1, we get the VA. From case number 2, we get the VC. And from case number 3, we get the VB to A and B to C. Now, this is the design moment and the maximum shear force. Now, once we get the maximum bending moment in the midspan and support, we can start the design. As in the problem, details of the beam are not given, and so we can design the beam AB and BC as a rectangular section instead of the plan section. Therefore, we have considered the design moment at the midspan of AB, it is 148.99. It is designed as a rectangular section. We have already assumed the cross section, that is B by D, that is a 230 by 540 instead of 230 by 400. Now assume DC dash is equal to 40 mm and calculate the moment of resistance MR for the balance section. RU max, M20 grade of concrete is there, Fe415 grade of steel is there, that's why it is 2.76 into B multiplied by D square. It is 158.70, and here bending moment for the design moment is 148, so we can design the single end cross section. And similarly, we have find out the AST at the midspan. AST required is equal to, using this formula, we get the AST is equal to 1009.75, which is less than AST minimum. And AST minimum is equal to, as per IS, 0.85 BD divided by FR. It is 235.54. Assume 20 mm as main reinforcement, we get the number of bars is equal to AST required divided by area of one bar, that is 3.21. So we have provided the 4 bars of 20 mm at the bottom in the span A. Now, for the midspan of the BC, Again, the maximum bending moment here, there are two bending moments. From case number 1, it is negative 6.707, and from the case number 2, 52.92 positive. So it is designed as a rectangular section. Assume cross section of the beam. Again, we have used the same cross section. We get the same moment of resistance, and then compare mu with the mu1. As mu design moment is less than mu1 for the balance section, we can design the single end cross section. Again, repeat the same procedure. We can find out the EST. It is only 311.21, which is greater than AST minimum, so no problem. We have considered 12 mm diameter as main reinforcement and find out the numbers. It is 2.75, so provide the 3 bars of 12 mm at bottom steel in span BC and to resist negative bending moment of 6.707 kN, provide the 2 bars of 12 at the top. That means it is designed as a double end section. Now, then we can find out the design the beam and the continuous support B. As we know that due to redistribution, we have transferred the moment from beam continuous support to the midspan, and that's why the section capacity is reduced. So it is necessary to find out the moment capacity, called as the section moment capacity after redistribution. And this will be find using the IS 456 2000 guidance. XU by D plus DM by 20, 100. DM is related with the percentage of redistribution, which is less than or equal to 0.6. So, XU by D is equal to KU limit for the continuous support after redistribution plus DM by 100. Here, DM 30%, that's why 30 divided by 100. So, we get the KU limit is equal to 0.3. It always less than or equal to KU max for the balance section. So, we can find out the RU limit, that is equal to 0.36 FCK into KU limit, 1 minus 0.42 into KU limit. So RU limit is equal to 1.88, MU limit is equal to MR, that is equal to RU limit multiplied by BD square. So MU limit is equal to 108.50 kN meter. Then we have compared the MU with the MU limit. As MU is less than MU limit, then the section is designed as a single end cross section. So we can find out again the AST at the support, which is 672.18. Then minimum, compare with the minimum AST, then assume 20 mm diameter as the reinforcement, then we get the 2 of 2.14. provide 2 of 20 plus 1 of 12 at top of the continued support to fulfill this requirement. So this can be done by taking the benefits of the bent up bars. Here in the span AB, we have provided the 4 bars of 20 mm. So out of 4 bars, we can curtail, or we have bent up the 2 bars, 2 of 20 from the span AB and 1 of 12 from the span BC. Out of 3 of 12, we can bent up the 1 bar of 12 mm. So no need to provide the extra steel at the support. Now this is the design of shear reinforcement. Again, we can find out the from the shear force case number 1, 2 and 3, we get the maximum shear force at support A, at support B, B to A, B to C and at support C. And from this, we can find out the maximum design shear force is 148.26 and for BC, it is 113.64. So, tau V is equal to VU by VD, that is the nominal shear stress, that is equal to 1.289 and 0.988. Then we can find out the percentage of steel provided at the support. 2 of 20 mm is bent up in the span BC, that's why 2 of 20 is available, that's why the percentage of steel is 0.546, and for BC it is 0.196 as 2 of 12 bar is available. Then tau C, we can find out the tau C from table number 19 and tau C max from table number 20, page number 72-73, IS 456 2000, we get the tau C and tau C max. Then compare tau V with tau C. Here it is observed that tau V is greater than tau C but less than tau C max, so design the shear reinforcement. Then we can find out the shear resisted by the concrete. So shear resisted by concrete is equal to tau C multiplied by BD. At tau C is known to us, multiplied by B is also known to you, D is also known to you, to get the shear resisted by concrete. Then shear resisted by bent up bars, here 2 of 20 is there, that's why as per IS it is 0.87 multiplied by Fy into ASB, here ASB, bent up bars, and multiplied by sin alpha, alpha is equal to 45 degrees. So it is 160.30, but this value should not exceed VU divided by 2. And so this is much more, so VUB is equal to 74.30. For the BC, one bar is bent up, one of 12 mm, so it is 28.84. This should not exceed VU by 2, it is 56.84. So we have considered 28.84. Then shear resisted by steel ups is equal to VU minus VC multiply minus VUB. That is the shear, total shear minus shear resisted by concrete minus shear resisted by bent up bars. Now this is the beauty of the bent up bars. Even though span is more, shear force is more, but due to bending the 22 bars of 20 mm, here the shear resisted by steel ups requirement is only 15.48. Here one bar of 12 mm is bent up, that's why it is more than this one. Even though the span is less, shear is also less. It is 49.15. Assume two leg vertical stirrups with diameter 6 mm, mild steel one. So we can find out the spacing again as per IS 456 2000. So 0.87 Fy into ASP, two leg vertical stirrups is there. That's why 2 multiplied by pi by 4 into square of 6 into D. That is the effective depth divided by VU, that is VU is shear resisted by the stirrups. So it is 397.20 and for BC it is 125. But SV max, maximum spacing for the stirrup, it should not exceed 0.87 Fy ASV divided by 0.4B or 0.75 times D, because we use the vertical stirrup. So it is 133.66 or 0.75 point into 500, it is 375. So take the lowest one. So we can provide the 6 mm mild steel at 125 mm center to center throughout the span ABC. Now, once we check the shear, we can design the shear reinforcement. Next is the check for deflection. Now, only for the large span, if it is satisfied, then for BC 100% satisfied because the cross section is same. D is equal to L by D basic multiplied by alpha 1 into alpha 2 into alpha 3. Alpha 1 is related with the tension strip, alpha 2 is related with the compression strip, and alpha 3 is related with the flange section. In our case, we have used the rectangular section, that's why this is 1. No compression strip is there, that's why this is also 1. So alpha 1, we can find out the alpha 1. So L is known to you, effective span is equal to 6 meter minus support, width of the support 230, that's why it is L. L by D basic, here one support is continue and second support is simple, that's why 26 plus 20 divided by 2, it is 23. Then we can find out the FS is equal to 0.58 Fy into AST required divided by AST provided. FS is equal to 193.50. Then from table number 4, IS 456, page number 36, alpha 1 is equal to 1.2. Alpha 2 is 1, singly reinforced section is there, alpha 3 is 1, rectangular section is there, and that's why D is equal to 209.05 mm, which is much less than the D provided, so it is safe. Generally in case of beam, check for deflection is not critical, but check for shear and development length, both are critical. It is exactly opposite in design of slab. In design of slab, deflection is critical. Now last, check for the development length, LD should be less than or equal to 1.3 M1 by V plus L0. So LD is equal to 47.5. So 20 mm diameter is used, so it is 940. L0 is the anchorage length, LS by 2, width of support by 2, minus clear cover plus 8 times of 5. Here we can also use the 12.5 instead of this, because we use the 90 degree bend. For every 45 degree bend, we can take the 4.5. So 4.5 multiplied by 2, it is 8.5. And for the binding purpose, again 4.5 is needed, straight length. So it is 12.5. So L0 is equal to 133, M1 is equal to 0.87 Fy, AST1, this is the AST at the discontinued support. D minus Fy divided by into AST divided by F sec into BD. This AST is related with the steel provided at the continuous support. So shear force, steel provided at the discontinuous support. So M1 100.52, VU at A discontinuous support, it is 114.93. So we can check LD is equal to 940 and the total availability is 1370, that's why no problem, it is safe. And last is the reinforcement detail. Now this is the reinforcement detail, and these are the section AA at the discontinuous support, section VB at the midspan, section CC at the continuous support, but from B to A, section DD continuous support, but toward discontinuous support C, and this is the midspan of BC, and this is the discontinuous support at C. Now this is here, we have considered the rectangular section, that's why all are rectangular. This is 2 of 10, anchor bar is there, and here 4 of 20. Out of 4 bar, 2 bars are bent up, and that's why 2 bars are available near the support. Similarly here, 1 of 12 is bent up, and here 2 of 20 is bent up, and that's why the requirement is 2 of 20 plus 1 of 12 at continuous support, which is fulfilled by using the bending the bars, 2 of 20 and 1 of 12. And this is the 3 bars of 12 mm, and out of 3, 1 is bent up like this, and again 1 of 12 at the top and 2 of 12 at the bottom. This is the reinforcement detail. Thank you. Thank you very much.